time around 1820. You know, in that time, and many years after, no official records was kept about colors, except for when they was bought and when they was sold. Yeah, I was born a slave, born into slavery, treated no better than cattle. When I was a little girl, about 5 or 6 years old, Master hired me out as a nursemaid to a woman named Miss Susan. I had to keep watch on the baby sleeping. Whenever the baby woke up and cried, I was whipped. One day I was beat 5 times before breakfast. Still got the scars to this day. One day I was working out in the fields, hard labor, when I came across a scuffle. One of the slaves had escaped and his master was trying to get me to help hold that slave down. I told him I would not do it. Well, that slave was running away and his master threw a big heavy weight at him, but it missed and hit me in the head instead. Ever since then, I would have seizures and get sick, but I would hear straight from the Lord after that. Even though I was born a slave, I knew I wasn't supposed to die one. I escaped by traveling through the Underground Railroad and made it all the way to freedom. When I found out I crossed that line, I looked at my hands to see if I was the same person. There was such a glory over everything, and the sun shone like gold through the trees and over the fields, and I felt like I was in heaven. I was free, but I had to help my people because they wasn't free. I started going back to Maryland and helping groups of slaves escape. I never lost a passenger. When they started the Civil War, I was right there with the soldiers. I was the first woman to lead an assault. Never did get a real pension though, and for the rest of my life I spent in terrible poverty. I always said, "'Twant me, 'twas the Lord." I always told him, "I trust you. I don't know where to go or what to do, but I expect you to leave me." And he always did.